I'm pushing so hard for this. I could win the MasterChef. But it will be great. Amazing. Life-changing.
Welcome to Wonderland. We've got it all. Potions and pastries that make you grow tall. Forests and cottages, castles and carts that can talk. Welcome to Wonderland, look where you're at. Maddest of hatters, the Cheshire Cat. Magical cabins and lovely white rabbits with clocks. Dancing through a dream underneath the stars. Laughing till the morning comes. Everyone that leaves has a heavy heart. Oh, Wonderland, I love. Welcome to Wonderland, I'll be your guide. Holding your hand under sapphire skies. Let's go exploring, or we could just go for a walk. Welcome to Wonderland, where should we go? There's a tea party along down the road. Make an appearance and maybe they'll sing us a song. Dancing through a dream underneath the stars. Laughing till the morning comes. One that leaves has a heavy heart. Oh, Wonderland, I love. Nothing around here is quite as it seems. Not sure if anything's real or a dream. And the only thing sure from the start is the song that's inside of your heart. Don't let it leave. If this was a dream, then at least I've got memories for when morning comes. I must leave with a heavy heart. Oh, Wonderland, I love.
Chefs, 1 hour has gone.
Shortest 1 hour, like it just gone, you know.
We haven't seen this hat before, Santosh, have we?
This hat is a very, very
special hat in Nepal. For a special event, you need to must wear this hat.
Today is a big, big, big moment. A big day for your life. 100% best I cannot give it. Cook with your heart, cook nice food, cook beautiful, and leave it to the God.
Santosh, if you do open your own Nepalese restaurant, will there always be a table for Monica, Marcus and me?
Yes, if I win today. I'm joking. It will be always the open door for you.
Santosh's menu sounds incredible, full of passion, full of energy and full of his love for Nepal.
We're starting with three mini starters from three different regions. The first one is called a crab chapati. It's on a crispy skin.
He's removing the white crab meat. He's adding some onion, puffed rice, some chaat masala, and lime juice. Love the sound of that.
We have a mushroom kebab on a deep fried plantain. So you can imagine the two put together, fried off.
And the third little morsel that we're going to try is lamb brain on a poppadom with pickled kohlrabi and grapes.
I love offal. I haven't had lamb's brains in over 15 years. They're beautiful, but it's not easy to get all the sinew out.
Yes.
The lamb brain, he's then going to coat them in the herbs and spices, seat them in the marinade for as long as possible, and then pan fry them right at the very end. For anyone that's never had them before, they're almost like the flavour and texture of sweetbread.
Whole competition is all a risk, so why not in the final as well? So let's do it. Maybe lamb brain make me winner, you know?
Santosh's main course, black spiced buffalo beef short rib.
I've had water buffalo. It is delicious. It's a much stronger meat compared to beef.
All the spices that Santosh is using for this dish are black. We've got cardamom, black peppercorns, black cumin, stone fungus, and cloves.
And then he's going to cook it in a pressure cooker to braise it down. That's the perfect way to cook this piece of meat. We want that just melting when you're eating it.
My worry is it can be not cooked, you know, maybe hard. So that is worried for me.
And any serving of a potato masala cannelloni. So I think it's going to be a crispy piece of potato, which is going to fill with spiced mashed potato.
Sounds delicious. Yes, please. I can't wait to try that.
Cannelloni need to be right color, right size. So it's lots of work. Lots of work in there. Oh. So you can see I'm running like a headless chicken now.
Santosh's dessert is a cardamom pistachio cake with a jaggery caramel. Jaggery is a type of hard sugar, so imagine a caramel out of that. Infused guava liquor, a coconut ice cream and lemon balm. Wow.
It blows my mind, the amount of spices and the way he uses all of the ingredients on his bench. I've not seen a chef in the MasterChef kitchen cook quite like Santosh.
And I have almost like 40 elements.
But can you seriously get all of this done?
Yes, I will. I need to push very, very fast. Oh my God, like so many things to do. How are you going to finish in 3 hours, you know? But Hindu religion have a million gods, you know? One will be free. One will be helping me around.
30 minutes. Big 30 minutes.
Let's rock on now. Okay.
You have got so much stuff on your bench, Santosh. Wow. Are you getting through everything?
Yes, yes.
On time?
Yeah, I will be time, chef. Yes.
Great. I hope you get everything done because I'm really looking forward to it.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah.
5 minutes, please.
5 minutes.
Santosh, last touches. We're rapidly running out of time here. Stop, that's it. Out of time.
Well done, guys. Well done, guys. Done.
Santosh, please, come and join us.
Wow, Santosh, what a feast, but I'm not surprised. It looks amazing. Can't wait to get started. Thank
you. To begin, Santosh has made a trio of Nepalese starters. White crab chapati, with brown crab meat foam served on spiced crispy chicken skin. Pan-fried lamb brain on mini poppadoms with pickled kohlrabi and grapes. And a wild mushroom kebab tiki served on plantain, topped with beetroot raita, cashew nut crumble, and a crispy curry leaf.
I like your idea. I've not had anything like this from you before. They're lamb brain, beautiful and soft. Absolutely like butter, melt in the mouth. Beautifully marinated, but just too strong. I just think you've just slightly missed the real star quality of the ingredients that you've used.
I would have wanted more of that crab, but delightful nonetheless there, Santosh. I find all three of them, the flavours and the spices, they gradually get stronger, yet uniquely different. You've still got textures through all three of them. Quite impressive. Great way to start.
What I like is you've taken us across Nepal. Mountains, valleys, and the grassy plains. Thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.
For his main, Santosh has made spiced buffalo beef short rib, sat on sautéed morning glory, potato masala cannelloni, gooseberry chutney, and a paratha bread filled with buffalo milk paneer, finished with a buffalo sauce and served with a glass of Nepalese rice wine.
Not everything on this plate is full of spice, and there are real points of difference. There's the lovely, almost sweet potato cannelloni on the side, the zing and the kick of the gooseberry, and I like the bread. It has a great flavour to it, and your sauce is a delight. The main course, I feel like I've really got stepped into your world, and that's sort of what we were waiting for.
I love your combination of flavours here. Your little gooseberry is an absolute devil of heat. My only issue is I think the buffalo could do with just being a little bit softer.
Really love the morning glory underneath the meat here. It's almost sort of spinach-like, and it's delightful. I thoroughly enjoy this. There's so much complexity in your cooking. What I have to say is it's delicious.
Santosh's dessert is cardamom and pistachio cake with a jaggery and lotus seed crisp crust, charred guava, and infused guava liqueur, served with a coconut ice cream.
I think your flavours are beautiful. Really quite mellow, quite different. It's a light cake. I'm getting nuttiness in there, and most certainly you get the cardamom. And then when that ice cream melts and you're just left with the beautiful mellow sweetness of coconut, I think it's a wonderful, wonderful dessert.
Coconut ice cream is really thick and got so much creaminess to it. It's almost like clotted cream. But I find the guava just a little bit on the crunchy, hard side. It's almost a little bit like eating a really underripe pear.
I personally love guava, so for me, this is a bit of taste at home. I like the caramel and then the lotus seeds that you've put around the cake, which gives it the texture. I just wish that you had more of that guava sauce because I think that would really lift this dessert. But I do love the flavours on here.
Thank you.
Santosh, throughout the competition, I've learned so much from you. And when you open your restaurant, I would love to come and spend some time in your kitchen and learn a bit more.
You've had a great competition, Santosh. You've had a great competition.
Thank you.
It went well, but not exactly what I wanted. Good luck for your best. You too. I'm happy as always. You can see I'm always happy and happy, happy, happy.
Santosh's food is an education in a cuisine that we knew nothing about until he walked in this door.
The chef has wanted to shine the light on the food of where he's from, and he's done a brilliant job doing that.
He carries that food around with him in his heart, and it shows.
I was fighting for my Masterchef champion, but I feel like I'm already Masterchef champion. Because of my
I needed to be saved. I was going crazy on my own.
I'm not to miss MasterChef, huh?
It took me years to tell my mother I expected the worst. I gathered all the courage in the world. She said, I love you no matter what.
I'm feeling great. Not winning and winning is part of life, you know.
To be happy, no,
I'm here properly, this kind of thing. I can say my I'm here.
She wrapped her arms around me.
Sorry, Alex.
She said, don't try to be what you're not.
Well,
cause I love you no matter.